Hey, welcome to my cooking series. It's Linda here. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make delicious okra soup. If you want to know how I make this beautiful, delicious, yummy, sumptuous okra soup which you're seeing, then please keep on watching this video. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, now is a good time to click on the subscribe button just right below. Now let's get right into it. So to make this soup, I'm using turkey, I'm using gizzard, I'm using stockfish to make this soup. So right now I'm putting my seasoning and I'm adding Maggi Star, the crayfish flavor, into the pot. Yeah, you can see the pot with the chicken, sorry, the turkey, the gizzard, the stockfish. Now I'm adding my salt. After adding my salt, next, guess what I'm going to add? I'm gonna put my onions. You thought it was gonna be pepper, right? I'm gonna put my onions next. So the essence of putting onions in this turkey and gizzard is just to make sure that the meat has more flavor, it has more taste. Because you know the thing with meat is if you don't season your meat well, it might not be very tasty. So I'm adding some cayenne pepper into this because me, your girl loves pepper, and I like my meat to taste like, you know, it tastes meaty, not taste like, oh, I'm eating something alive. So next, I'm gonna add some uziza seed, grinded uziza seed. That's after I've stirred in the pepper and the other spices which I already added initially. So let's just turn this up with my turning wood or turning spoon, whatever you want to call it here. I'm just gonna stir the meat in together with the seasoning. Then that's my uziza seed. I grinded uziza seed. So I'm gonna add that uziza seed in to just use it to add more flavor to the meat. Yes. So I'm gonna turn that in together again. After stirring it together, what I'm gonna do next is I'm just going to cover the meat up and let it cook for at least 30 minutes. And while my meat is cooking, I'm going to take time to chop my okra and start with prepping the okra to introduce the cooked meat into the okra. So now what I'm doing, I'm just pouring palm oil into that big pot you're seeing. What I'm going to do now is just bleach the oil and fry some onions in it, season the onions a bit before I then introduce the okra. So I fry my okra the same way we tend to always fry our egusi. That's how I fry my okra. So if you've never tried the method of cooking okra soup whereby your okra is being fried, please, from today, after you watch this video, I want you to try this method. If you want to cook the most delicious okra soups ever, try this recipe. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just adding my onions into the pot, and I'm going to stir that onions in, fry it until it's slightly tender, and also put some salt in it while I'm also frying the onions. Measurement of the salt that I'm going to use is just about a teaspoon of salt. So I just poured in that salt into the pot, and I'll continue stirring it together. Yeah, this is to make sure that the onion has some flavors. The oil also has a bit of taste to it. And I'm going to use that oil right there to now fry my okra. Yes. So next, I'm going to reach out for my okra right now. And I'm going to start scooping the okra into the pot. Just try and be gentle while you are doing this so you don't have your okra falling all around your cooking area. Just do it slowly, 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 gently, just to make sure everything gets into the pot without falling off. I'm trying to make sure I don't lose any okra because, man, this soup is going to be so delicious. I wouldn't want to lose any okra that could go with a bowl of garri. So, did I say a bowl of garri? Maybe one hand swallow of garri. So let's just take it gently. Just slide everything into the pot. Yeah. Now we're almost done with this part. Yeah, I'm just trying to make sure I clean out that tree into the pot. Yeah. Yes, so now it's time for us to now meticulously fry our okra. So I'm using that cooking spoon and I'm just stirring the okra in, turning it around just to make sure that all the parts of this okra is fried. Just turning it around, making sure I get a good fry. Yes, let's turn it around. If you want your okra soup to be very, very drawing and not all this type of okra soup that you cook okra but it still seems kind of watery, try this method. When you fry your okra very well, it makes the okra draw more and it makes it taste like okra, not like it's going to be tasting sort of like it needs to be cooked. It won't taste like it's still alive. So the palm oil was not enough, so I just added in just one cooking spoon of palm oil, and I'm going to continue frying my okra. Very easy process, guys. Like, who knew cooking okra can be so easy? If you try this my recipe and your husband does not clean it, lick his fingers, or as a guy you cook okra soup and your babe eats it, or your wife eats it and she doesn't lick her fingers, just come back and get a refund from me. Come back, the money you spent on buying your cooking materials, come, I'll give it back to you. Just try this my recipe. I can assure you that anybody that eats your soup will love it. Even you yourself, you will love it. So you can see the okra now. I think I'm almost done with frying it. Like, everything has been well fried. The okra is a bit tender now and it looks good. So at this point, I can now add my meat to the okra. Yeah, see how it looks. Everything has been well fried. It looks good. It's drawing. It's nice. Yeah. And it's beautiful. Very beautiful. So I'm going to just pour in my meat into the okra. You can see the chicken, the turkey, the gizzard, the stockfish. I'm just going to stir it in, just make sure I turn it really well into that okra soup so it cooks with the okra, and just add a bit of liquid to the soup to make the soup a little more like, you know, like soupy, so it's not like veggie without liquid. But guys, for this my okra soup, I don't even bother I don't add any more water. The only water I add to the soup is just the water from the meat. That water is more than enough for me. But if you feel like you want your okra soup to be a bit more watery, then you can proceed to add more water. But for me, I like my okra soup to be very thick, so I didn't bother adding any more water. I felt like the water from the meat is more than enough water. So what I'm going to proceed now to doing is just adding my crayfish. After adding my crayfish, I'm also going to add okporo. You know, that's grinded prawns. Yeah, grated, grinded, blended prawns. That's what I just added now. So that's crayfish and okporo in there. I'm going to now stir it in together. Then maybe after I've turned the soup a bit more, then I can choose to now add my uziza seed. That's the blended uziza seed. Yeah, that's uziza seed. Guys, try putting uziza seed in your okra soup. I can assure you that you're going to love it. It's just going to add a little bit of flavor to the okra and just make it more spicy. So let's just turn in those, let's just stir those ingredients in together. Right now, I'm trying to taste the okra to see if it needs a little more maggi in it or salt in it. And I think it needs just at least 1 cube of maggi and a little salt. But I'll just keep on turning it, and I'll definitely add the remaining maggi that I want to add to it much later. Yeah. Let's see how nice the soup is. Very thick, just the way I love it. If you like your soup a little more watery, please do also add more water to it. But me, this is how I like mine, so I'm not even bothering myself with adding water to it. So if you ever teased as a child, or maybe just teased, you're currently being teased now that you turn your soup too much, and for that reason you don't know how to cook, the people that don't know how to cook are people that like turning their food, don't mind them. If you taste this soup is a banger. So I just added in that 1 cube of maggi chicken stock, and I'm just stirring in that maggi into the soup, and I'm just gonna allow it cook a little before I then set my pot aside. But yeah, just add a little salt, just very little. It's almost like we didn't add anything, but just very little salt. It's very important. It's better for the salt in your soup to be under, that is, to not be enough, than for the salt in your soup to be too much, because once the salt in your soup is too much, there's almost nothing you can do to it. So be very careful with salt seasoning your soup too much. So I'm just stirring in that seasoning so that it cooks for a bit. You can see how it looks now. I'm just adding a little more Cameroon pepper to make the soup more spicy. Yes, just to make the soup a little more spicy. You know, the thing with using gizzard and turkey to cook soup is. Those are not the most tasty meat for cooking soup. So you need to make sure that you add a little, add in more seasoning just to make sure that the meat still has taste and the soup is also still tasty. So just added in some fresh pepper to the soup just to give the soup a more beautiful color. Yeah, you can see how it looks so beautiful, so beautiful. And next I'm just going to start stirring that pepper. Just stir the soup in for a bit, let it cook for at least a few seconds or at least 1 minute before I just turn off my gas and call it a day with this okra soup. And take note, with this okra soup I'm not putting any vegetable, so this is okra soup without vegetable. If you feel like you like vegetable in your okra, you can proceed now to add your vegetable. For me, no vegetable in my okra soup. So you can see how the soup looks. It's very beautiful. It looks very delicious. It is actually very delicious. Very, very delicious. Try this recipe out. If you like the turnout of how your soup comes out, let me know in the comment section. And if you want to see more food recipes on my channel, please let me know in the comment section as well. If you're looking for a market where you can buy affordable foodstuffs in Nigeria, in Lagos to be precise, I bought the foodstuff which I used for this soup in Oyinbo Market. I think I got a carton of chicken for a carton of turkey for around 28,000 naira. I bought all the okra which I used for this video was just 1,000 naira. Like, things are just sort of affordable there, unlike the market around my area. So if you can go far and buy your foodstuffs, you get it at a more affordable price. But guys, look at how this soup looks. So beautiful. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends who you would love them to learn how to cook their okra soup. Or share it with your wife if you want her to cook okra soup the way I cook mine. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next food series.